Okay, we're taking a look at the door today. The first coat of Waterlox Marine Sealer and Zar Stain Mix has been applied. A second coat of the Stain and Waterlox Mix was applied to various panels that were maybe a little lighter than the rest of the door to try to bring them all into an average, and it looks like we've got a real nice variation without... Got a few panels that are a little dark, but that's the nature of the wood. It's going to stain however it stains. But the Waterlox Stain Mix seems to get a little more even distribution of color than if just a straight stain alone. So we really do like this mix, but we also want to emphasize, do not sand this coat. Now, that's a unique thing about Waterlox Marine Sealer anyway. We normally don't sand the first coat. We like that second coat to go on, get down in some of these cracks, flow on down. There's just a little bit of raised fuzz, not much. Easily sanded out of the next coat if needed at all. You don't have to sand Waterlox between coats for adhesion. We only sand the Waterlox just simply for aesthetics and feel. Now this is a garage door, it's not a piece of furniture, but it's hard not to treat it like one when you can make it this beautiful. So this is just one coat of the first coat of the sealer. Second coat applied to a few of the panels. You can see where they're a little shiny at an angle where they got that second coat, but things will look a little more uniform after this coat. Just a clear coat of sealer, and then we'll go with two coats of the marine satin finish. Let's get started for today. We're going to apply a coat of the Waterlox Marine Sealer untinted to the entire door. Let's get started.